So this question says, a grove has six rows of birch trees. So I'm going to say B has six rows and five rows of maple trees. So M has five rows. Each row of birch trees has eight trees 20 feet or taller and six trees shorter than 20 feet. Okay, so in a row, you have eight that are 20 feet tall or taller, so 8/20, so how I'll represent that. I'll say 20 plus. And six that are 20 minus or shorter than 20. All right, so that row has 14 trees basically, and there's six rows that look like that. The next sentence says each row of maple trees has nine trees 20 feet or taller. So for maple, there are nine that are 20 or taller, and seven trees shorter than 20, right? So, and seven that are 20 or shorter. A tree from, so again, that means that each row for maple has a total of 16 trees. Okay, so there are 16 trees per row for maple, 14 trees per row for birch, eight of which are 20 feet or taller, six of which are 20 feet or shorter than 20 feet, I should say. And then there are 16 trees per row of maple, nine of which are 20 feet or taller, and seven of which are shorter than 20 feet. A tree from one of these rows will be selected at random. What is the probability? So anytime we see this word probability, we're going to think about a fraction. That fraction has a numerator of what we want, right? How many ways in which we can get what we want. And the denominator will always be the total. What are we choosing from, right? So a tree from one of these rows will be selected at random. So how many rows do we have? Well, we have a total of 11 rows, but each row there's 30 trees, right? So I'm just gonna, I don't know if I want 11 down here, my denominator, if I want 30 times 11. So I'll see if there's any clarifying information regarding that. What is the probability of selecting a maple tree given that the tree is 20 feet or taller? Okay, so given that the tree is 20 feet or taller means that we're only choosing from trees that are 20 feet or taller. So for birch, how many trees are 20 feet or taller? Eight per row. There are six rows, right? That means there are 48 trees that are 20 feet or taller. So our total here is going to be 48 for the birch. For the maple, there are nine trees per row that are 20 feet or taller, but we have a total of five rows. So that makes there be 45 total trees, 45 total maple trees that are 20 feet or taller. So I'm going to add 45. So altogether, given that the tree is 20 feet or taller, meaning I'm only choosing from trees that are 20 feet or taller, I have a total of 93 trees that are 20 feet or taller. Now, if I want to select a maple tree that's 20 feet or taller, that means my numerator is going to be for the maple, right? Which is the fact that there's 45 of those trees. So there's 45 total trees, 45 total maple trees that are 20 feet or taller. So that's what I want. That's the number that represents what I want. And this total represents the total number of trees that I'm choosing from. So I would have 45 over 93. So I think I can reduce that. I think 3 goes into both of these things. So 3 goes into 45 15 times, right? So I'm just dividing by 3 to reduce it. 3 goes into 45 15 times. 3 goes into 93 31 times. And there's our answer. 15 over 31 cannot be reduced further. So our answer here is choice C.